Unveiling the Even Distribution Fallacy in Investing. The even distribution fallacy is a critical concept for investors to understand, as it can significantly impact investment strategies and outcomes. This fallacy occurs when an individual assumes that the returns or characteristics of a large group will be evenly distributed among its constituents, without considering the variability or specific characteristics of individual elements within that group. Understanding the even distribution fallacy. At its core, the even distribution fallacy is about oversimplification. It's the mistaken belief that outcomes or characteristics observed at a macro level will uniformly apply at a micro level. In the context of investing, this fallacy can manifest in several ways, often leading to suboptimal investment decisions. Examples in investment scenarios. Stock market index performance. Consider an investor looking at the performance of a stock market index like the S&P 500. If the index has returned 10% over a year, the even distribution fallacy would lead to the assumption that each stock in the index also returned approximately 10%. In reality, some stocks may have skyrocketed, while others plummeted. The index's overall performance is an aggregate of diverse individual performances. Real estate investment. In real estate, an investor might assume that a 5% annual increase in housing prices in a particular city applies evenly across all neighborhoods. However, some areas might see a much higher appreciation due to factors like development projects, while others might even depreciate. Sector allocation. When a particular sector, like technology or healthcare, is booming, investors might fall into the trap of thinking that all companies within that sector are equally profitable. In reality, while some companies might be driving the growth, others might be lagging due to poor management or outdated products. The dangers of the even distribution fallacy. Misallocation of resources. By not recognizing the variability within a group, investors may misallocate their resources, investing equally in high and low performers. Underestimation of risk. It can lead to a significant underestimation of risk. Not all constituents of a group share the same risk profile, and treating them as such can expose investors to unexpected losses. Missed opportunities. This fallacy can cause investors to miss out on lucrative opportunities by not identifying the outliers that significantly outperform the average. Strategies to overcome the even distribution fallacy. Investors can adopt several strategies to counteract the even distribution fallacy and enhance their investment decision-making process. Segmentation and targeted analysis. Instead of viewing an investment group as a monolith, segment it into more manageable and distinct categories. For example, within a stock index, consider factors like industry, market capitalization, and growth versus value stocks. Analyzing these segments separately can provide a clearer picture of where the real value and risks lie. Historical performance analysis. Look at the historical performance of individual assets within a group, not just the group's aggregate performance. This analysis can reveal patterns and outliers that are not apparent at the group level. Risk assessment at the micro level. Assess the risk at an individual asset level. Different investments within the same category can have vastly different risk profiles due to factors like management quality, financial health, market position, and exposure to economic cycles. Regular portfolio review. Regularly reviewing and rebalancing your portfolio can help in identifying areas where the assumption of even distribution might have led to suboptimal investment choices. Real-world implications of the fallacy. The even distribution fallacy isn't just a theoretical concept, its implications are evident in real-world scenarios. Market crashes and corrections. During market downturns, sectors or indexes that seemed uniformly strong can reveal significant weaknesses. Investors who assumed an even distribution of strength across all assets might face unexpected losses. Emerging markets investment. Investors often treat emerging markets as a homogeneous group. However, countries within this group can vary widely in terms of political stability, economic growth, and market maturity. Technological disruption. In sectors undergoing technological disruption, assuming that all companies will equally benefit from or be harmed by these changes can be a critical mistake. Some companies adapt and thrive, while others struggle to keep up. Educational and behavioral aspects. Understanding the even distribution fallacy also involves recognizing the psychological and educational factors that contribute to it. Heuristics and bias. The fallacy often stems from cognitive biases and heuristics. For instance, the availability heuristic might lead investors to focus on readily available aggregate data rather than digging deeper into individual data points. Financial education. Improving financial literacy can help investors understand the complexities of markets and investment products, reducing the likelihood of falling prey to this fallacy. Behavioral finance counseling. Engaging with professionals who specialize in behavioral finance can help investors identify and overcome cognitive biases affecting their investment decisions. The even distribution fallacy is a reminder of the complexities of investing. It underscores the importance of detailed analysis, continuous education, and an awareness of cognitive biases in the investment process. By acknowledging and addressing this fallacy, investors can make more informed decisions, better manage risks, and potentially improve their investment returns. Remember, in the world of investing, the devil often lies in the details. If you find these topics interesting, join our Discord, link below, to help us to open source Wall Street. Thank you.